point and the final point. We are more than conquerors. Conquerors can win a battle and not celebrate. Conquerors can win a battle and not celebrate. There are kinds of victories. There are two kinds of victories. There is the victory that is called Pyrrhic victory. P-Y-P-H-Y-R-I-C. Pyrrhic victory. What is a Pyrrhic victory? The pastor is talking too much grammar. Let me explain. A Pyrrhic victory is a victory that is won, but was won at a great cost. So much so that you can't really celebrate. Case in point, Samson. Samson actually had a victory over the Israelites even after they had captured him, after they plucked out his eyes. He asked God, said, God, let me defeat these people this one more time, restore my strength. And God restored his strength. And he actually, according to the Bible, he killed more of the Philistines than any other time in Islam history. He won the victory, but at what cost? He couldn't really celebrate because he also died. It was a victory, but it was a Pyrrhic victory. I'm declaring that in 2018, you will win clear-cut, celebrated victories in the mighty name of Jesus. And so we are more than conquerors because a conqueror can win a Pyrrhic victory. A victory that comes at great cost that they can't even rejoice. There's no time to rejoice. Under Pyrrhic victory, you can also talk about uncelebrated victory or incomplete victories. If you look at Judges chapter 1, Judges chapter 1 verse 8, Judges chapter 1 verse 8, and then verses 19 and 21, you see an incomplete victory. It says, now the children of Judah had fought against Jerusalem and had taken it and smitten it with the head of the sword and set the city on fire. But go to verse 19. And the Lord was with Judah, and he drove out the inhabitants of the mountains, but could not drive out the inhabitants of the valley. Incomplete victory. I declare that every incomplete victory in your life up to this point, as you enter into 2018, the Lord will give you a total complete victory in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, let me say that again. Every incomplete victory. You have won in one leg. You are losing in another leg. You have won in one part. You are losing in another part. Today, as this year is terminating, amen, that half victory is turning into full victory. Amen. It's turning into full victory. Amen. If you believe, say, I receive complete victory. Amen. There's also uncelebrated victory, still under Pyrrhic victory. It's a victory that cannot be celebrated. I bring you the story of Saul. If you go to 1 Samuel chapter 15, you see the story of Saul. Saul actually went out and he defeated the enemy. He made a mess of them. But because of one significant disobedience, he couldn't celebrate the victory. He actually won the battle. If you read it very well, let's go to 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 7. And Saul smote the Amalekites from Havilah until thou comest to Shur that is over against Egypt. It was a long battle, and he defeated them, and he defeated them thoroughly. But if you go to verse 13, go to 1 John 15, 13, you see that he could not really celebrate because he did not completely obey the Lord. But then the only reason why we may not be more than conquerors is if we don't completely align ourselves with what God has said. And maybe where we then struggle so far is because we have not completely aligned ourselves with what God has said. It is not so much as if God is waiting for you not to succeed. No, it is because God has a pattern and a way in which he dispenses his favor, he dispenses his goodness, he dispenses his mercy, he dispenses his grace. Because let me say this to you as we begin to round up. The grace of God is what makes the difference between between Pyrrhic victory and triumphant victory is the grace of God. But you need to have the heart for it. What is the difference between King Saul and King David? If you look at both of their lives, you could say that they both had almost equal evil on their hand. Almost equal. As a matter of fact, that of David, you could even say, was even very worse, because David murdered one gentleman for nothing. But because of his heart, he had a heart of repentance. If he hears the word of God, he does not contend against it. He can come down. He can humble himself quickly. He doesn't look for shortcuts. He obeys even when he's wrong. And when he's brought a correction, he follows through. That is such a heart that the Bible says that I honor that those who honor me. That's why the Bible says that those who are humble are the ones that God lifts up. It is a key element between being a conqueror or being more than conqueror. When you are more than conqueror, your victories will be complete and total triumphant victory, because God is always looking for people that he will use to show the world that he is the king, that he is the Lord of the heart. And that is what he wants to do in 2018. He wants to give us triumphant victory, like he gave to the Israelites in Exodus 14, like he gave to David in 1 Samuel chapter 17. You see the story very well. David said that the battle is the Lord. That is how you should be talking regarding your life in 2018. The battle is the Lord. And God has never lost a battle. God doesn't win Pyrrhic victories. God doesn't win uncelebrated victories. God is not in the business of incomplete victories. If you align with God, if you develop a humble heart that does not gainsay the word of God, a humble heart that is ready to be corrected and to be led in the way of the Lord, there is no way in this world that your victory will not be completed. That is why the Lord has asked me to tell you that 2018 is the year of the victory that triumphs. I want you to rise up, brethren, and begin to first of all thank God and say, Father, thank you for the word that you have put me as I'm crossing over to 2018. I receive the triumphant victory. I receive the triumphant victory. I overcome and I am more than the conquerors. Now I want to begin to talk to him in the last few minutes and say, Father, every incomplete victory will become completed in the mighty name of Jesus. Every battle where I have struggled, as I'm going into 2018, I will receive a celebrated victory. Every victory that I have had but I cannot celebrate, there is a transformation. I want you to begin to call 2018 the name that you want it to be. We have just 2 minutes to go. Why don't you begin to give 2018 a name? I will give it the name and say it's my year of triumphant victory. It's the year of triumphant victory in my family. It is the year of triumphant victory in Jesus Christ Assembly. It is the year of triumphant victory in your family, in the life of your children, in your finances, in your education, in your career, in that immigration case. It is the life of total complete victory. God and give 2018 a name. That is what you need to do as you cross over to 2018. Give it a name. And I say, 2018, hear the word of God. I call you a year of triumphant victory. This is the year of my celebration. This is the year of my complete victory. Every doubt is out of the way. Every defeat is out of the way. Every failure in my life will be eliminated. Why don't you make that declaration? Everything that represents Pharaoh, just like God dealt with Pharaoh in Exodus 14, that is how the Pharaohs of my life, that is how they will end. 2018, in the termination of slavery. Why don't you declare it? 2018 is the termination of slavery. 2018 is the termination of oppression. 2018 is the termination of poverty. 2018 is the termination, of sickness. 2018 is the termination of affliction. It is the beginning of celebrated victories. Let's begin to shout the name of Jesus. Happy New Year. The Lord has to tell you that this is the year of your healing. That the doctor's report will be contradicted. God is contradicting the doctor's report. 2018 you will receive that healing that they have said is not possible. That healing that they said is not possible. 2018 you will receive it. I'm going to give you 2 or 3 minutes to talk to God.